Hey guys, what's happening? Thanks for tuning in, coming back and watching. I appreciate it. Hope you're having a super great day. I am playing around in the public beta of On One Photo Raw 2020. It is a free public beta. If you're interested, you can get it at the link down below. It's kind of fun to download the new stuff and try it out. I believe the new product launches in October, and they do a public beta, which is fun for us because we all get a copy of it and get to experiment. And that's exactly what I'm doing in this video. There are a number of new features in the 2020 version. I may touch on a few of them, but this is not a tutorial that outlines, you know, I'm not outlining all of the new stuff. I'm just going to talk about a few things and show you a couple filters that are new that I used on this photo edit. So let's hop into it. Here's the photo that I started with. And after applying a number of filters, including some new ones, I came up with this. Much brighter. I've got the sun beaming down. I've increased contrast. I've made the image really pop. So starting with the before to the after, pretty significant change. So I'm going to reset all these filters, and then we'll walk through that edit. Okay, here I am in the Develop tab, and this is before I did anything. Of course, that's the original image. And this is what it looks like after going through the tone and color section. And of course, as you can see, lens correction has been applied. It was there. That's with lens correction on. So in the tone and color section, I just did some basic stuff, a little contrast, highlights, shadows, midtones, and a little bit of color work. Really pretty simple stuff. I just wanted to get the base image, which, you know, it has some decent color in it, but it's kind of flat light, and give it a little bit of pop, brighten some of those shadows, and straighten it out a little bit in terms of lens correction. So that's where I was. And then really the next thing was hopping over to the effects tab. So the first thing I did was hit dynamic contrast. You know, let me turn that off. If you look, especially like in the bricks here and some of these bushes, it's kind of flat and lacking any punch. And dynamic contrast is great at kind of amping up those things. So I applied that pretty gentle, just medium and large at 15 and 20. In fact, those are the default settings. I didn't feel like I needed to go any more. And I didn't really want to go any less. I felt like it fit just right like that. Next was sunshine. And let me show you again before. If you look at the sky, the blue's a little bit more prominent. And the sunshine filter, while I like it and it warms up the scene quite a bit, it does wash out some of that blue. So even though I went kind of subtle here on sunshine, the blues were kind of washed out. And so that's why I came back next with color adjustment. And as you can see, I took the blues down pretty significantly. To do that, you just click on the blue, and then you can make adjustments here. I bumped up the saturation fairly high, and then I reduced the brightness to negative 100. And while I don't really recommend going negative 100 on a lot of images, I did here for a particular reason. I was more so something like that, but I ended up going negative 100, and that's because I also use this new filter called Sun Flare. So let me turn that on. And as you can see, it does a marvelous job of adding the sun flare, creates a lot of warmth in the image, but it really does also reduce that blue in the sky. So there's before. Let me show you, if I had not turned on or used color adjustment and just used sun flare, the sky's gonna end up being kind of almost white, right? And I didn't like that. I like the blue quite a bit. For me, part of what makes the scene is the blue and the kind of orangey yellow tones in that castle that I think look good together. So that's why I worked on color adjustment to bring that blue luminance down so that when I added sun flare, I still had some. Now, sun flare, you've got a few options here in this filter. You can get bokeh, sun flare, or sun star. And on any of them, if you click on it, you've got a drop-down menu that has a number of different options. And as you can see, I can just move around and I can stick the sun flare in different places based on whatever this overlay looks like. I went with number one, sun flare, and I reduced it to about 41 on the amount, and then I reduced the opacity to about 70, 71. So let me show you what it would look like if I was at 100 and 100, right? So it'd be way too strong for my taste. So I came down to, I think, 41 here, and like, let's call it 70 here. It's just a nice kind of subtle sun flare. There's before and after. It's not really that subtle, to be honest, but I think it looks fine in this photo, and I think it kind of goes with the scene. I was warming up the scene. I'm bringing back the warmer tones, the oranges and yellows that are in the castle. I use the sunshine filter below, and then this time I use the sun flare just to make it pop a little bit. And I like where I am, but I had one more thing I wanted to do, and that's also using a new filter, and this new filter is called Color Balance. And what I did there is I just went into the highlights and I dragged the hue to about 27 and the amount to 52. And if you just look at the highlights, which is really the sun flare itself, before it was kind of washed out, a little bit white, and after I just went into highlights because those are definitely the brightest parts of the photos, and I just picked a warm hue and dragged that amount slider over to the right just to give some warmth to that sun flare itself. So that's a way you can use filters. They're both new, both Color Balance and Sun Flare, but you can use them in combination to sort of adjust the look of what the sun flare is going to do to your photo. So there's Sun Flare without the color balance, and there it is with color balance. It just gives it a little bit more warmth. Now there's some additional filters. There's a bunch of new presets. There's a couple of other filters. There's one called Weather that allows you to add like snow and rain. There's a channel mixer as well that does some really cool effects. And there's also a print module over here that's been really, it's fairly robust. As I said, this is not a full tutorial on the complete update to On One Photo Raw 2020. I just thought I wanted to talk a little bit about some of these new filters and show you a sample edit and how I use a couple of these new filters in combination to achieve the look that I'm going for in the photo. So one more time, here's the before with nothing, and here's the after with some of the edits, including new filters in On One 2020. So thanks for watching. I hope that it's helpful. I'd love to hear what you think about these. I will be doing more videos. I'm going to experiment with some more photos in On One and probably talk about some of these features as I go through them. I just didn't want to call this a preview video because I'm not really previewing all the different features. So that's it, my friends. By all means, leave me a comment down below. Let me know what your thoughts are. And if you don't have the public beta, check it out at the link below. And you can also, if you do have it, love to hear what you're doing with it and what you think about it. So that's it, my friends. I appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching. Have a good one. I'll see you soon with another video. Take care and adios.